see. And all of a sudden, I'm unaware of these afflictions eclipse my glory and realize just how beautiful you are now. Greet your affections are for me.
Piece of cardboard. Some of you guys see it on the street. You just kick it around. But it's so messed up how crazy just one piece of cardboard, and you without you saying anything, can give such a powerful testimony of what God is doing in your life or He has done in your life. Amen. You know, at a young age, I was selling drugs out of my mom's house. I was doing drugs. I was drinking as much as I could. I was having sex. I was doing all kinds of things because nobody introduced me to Christ. Nobody talked to me about Christ. Nobody gave me that opportunity. And when I was given the opportunity, I grabbed a hold of it and I ran with it. And you would never think a guy who dropped out of high school who was on drugs, who was selling drugs, who was making good money doing that out on the street. Could a person like that ever become a youth pastor? Let me tell you, God is no respecter of person.
What'd you say?
And if he's done things for me in my life, he can do things for you in your life. Amen. You know, the Bible says that the enemy, he comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And right now, he's at work as much as he can. But the second part of that verse, says that Jesus, that he came to give us life. I said he came to give us life. And he wants us to live that abundant life. Amen. He wants us to live a life, a mindset in Christ and who he is. Amen. And who we're called to be. The second thing he came for was, the Bible says that Christ came into the world to do what? To destroy the works of the devil. And if we're all for Christ, what is our mentality? What should it be? Our mentality is to be, let's destroy the work of the devil.
Yes.
And for 9 long years, we've been destroying the works of the devil.
Thank you, God.
So we wanted to give you guys the opportunity to share these cardboard testimonies with you. Maybe some of the young people here, even adults, are going through depression. Maybe you're lonely. Maybe you feel like you've been cast out and you've been abandoned. Maybe you feel like that way. Maybe you feel, let's take it a little bit deeper. Maybe you feel suicidal and rejected. Let's go ahead and bow our heads, everybody. Let's pray. Nobody looking around. Everybody go ahead and bow your heads real quick. Father, tonight, we just want to say thank you, Lord. We just want to glorify your name, Father. We give you glory in this house, Father. We just want to be witnesses unto your name, Father, and the power and the authority that you have, Lord. Father, glorify yourself. If anything else, glorify yourself tonight, Jesus. With every eye closed, every head bowed, maybe you're here tonight. And you say, you know what? I don't know much about the God that you're talking about tonight, Pastor. I haven't given God a full chance in my life. But tonight, I'm willing to. Tonight, I'm willing to step out and make that change. Or maybe you're here and you follow God to the fullest, but you've drifted away from God. And you're not where you're supposed to be. And God is chasing after you. And you have not submitted to him. If you want to rededicate your life tonight, if that's you, everybody close your eyes. This is a very important moment right now. This is a very important moment for you. If that's you, you want to say, Pastor, I'm willing to give God a chance in my life tonight. I want you to take a step of faith. I just want you to raise your hand and say, that's me. I want to give God a chance in my life tonight. I see some hands going up. Don't be ashamed, guys. Nobody looking around. Nobody looking around. Forget about the friends that are next to you. If that's you, I want to give you, God, a chance in my life tonight to turn me into a living testimony. If that's you, keep your hand up. Maybe it's you who say, I've fallen away from God. And I don't know what to do. I need to take that next step. I want to come back to the cross, to my first love, my first personal relationship that I had with him. If that's you, I want you to raise your hand tonight. All of you guys who are raising your hands, I'm proud of you guys, but I need you to take another step. I want you to come out into the aisle, and I want you to come forward. I want you to meet me right here. I need you to take another step, and I want you to come meet me right here in the front. If you raise your hand tonight, I want you to come meet me in the front. If you're saying, I want to give my life to Christ because I don't know about this God thing, but I'm willing to give it a chance, I want you to come to the front. Don't be ashamed, man. Don't be ashamed. know, the word says that you're either for me or you're against me. There is no in between. So I see some young men and women coming to the front right after I said that. Come on. Tell you something is about to happen right now. Something is about to happen right now. This is one of the most important decisions that you will ever make. Amen. What I want to do with all the people here is I want you guys to just go ahead and bow your heads. Can the congregation just stretch your hands toward them and let's pray for them quietly as they repeat after me. Guys here in the front, I want you to repeat after me, amen. All right, Lord.
Speak louder.
Lord.
I thank you.
That I came here tonight. I didn't come here to have fun. But I realize the whole purpose of you bringing me here was for you. And right now, God, I offer you my life. I give you my life. Tonight, I make the decision to follow you all the rest of my days. Father, I admit that I'm a sinner. And right now, I ask you to cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Wipe everything clean right now, God. I hand it all over to you, Lord. All my troubles, all my depression, all those suicidal thoughts, I ask you to kill them right now in the name of Jesus. Louder, guys, I believe that you died and that you arose on the third day. And I believe that you sit at the right hand of God the Father, alive, well, and in charge. In Jesus' name. Can you get a hand clap for all these people? Listen, guys, the Bible says that there's a big party in heaven over one sinner that just gives his life to Christ. So you think this is a party? There's a big party in heaven. This is the next step. The next step, guys, is to get in this youth group. If you're a youth, join this youth group. Let me tell you something. Not only join, commit to this youth group to say, God, I believe that you sent me here to be fed, to be matured in Christ, and I'm going to be coming here every single week. I need you guys to tell your pastor, I'm after this thing, pastor, I'm going to be coming every week because I made this decision, man, and I got to stick to it. Amen? I challenge you to get a Bible. To get a Bible and start reading the book of John about Jesus' love, about Jesus' forgiveness, and all about the kindness and the love that he has for you. Start reading in that book. Amen? Pastor?
Come on, give all of them a hand. Come on, the Bible declares that heaven rejoices over one. Amen. Come on, let us reach heaven. Let us make some noise. Now listen, I want our new converts, after the service, I want our new converts to be some of the first ones to sign our Not Ashamed banner. Amen. Because this ain't something that we can put on your bushel, but we put it on the candlestick that it get light to all that is in the house, so that everybody will know the choice that you made on tonight. Amen. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. God bless you. You may be seated.